guys, so just now we are you saw that what we are going to create today from scratch using no any other plugin. It will be just only hard coded everything. So now in my on my screen you can see I have just created a basic Flutter project. I have just created a basic stateful. So I have created a basic stateful homepage, stateful widget called homepage. So now we are going to create, we just need to remove this test folder. Now we are going to create two more files which will be helpful for us to create more animations. So let me name this directory as utils. Now we will create two dart files, one called pulse dot dot, and there is called selector dot dot. So now first we are going to start with pulse dot dot. So let's see what we have to write there. So first of all, we are going to create a stateful widget called pulse. So the part of pulse is not completely developed by me. It is kind of inspired from a plugin. So you can see the majority of code is kind of not used. So just okay if you find it for if you find something like that, you can remove it as per your need or as you find it perfect for your use case. I'm just importing basic requirements. Okay, so this is to be required. So now here we have created some basic pulse architecture for pulse. So just as I told, majority of code of pulse is not written by me, so we are going to import those things from here now. Just don't worry, it just moves because it auto formats itself. Okay, so let me show you. So these are basic widgets or basic things which we might not use, but these were used by the developer. So I think you can just pause and copy this part, because I am not going to type all these things because it is very big code and it might waste too much time to do it everything from scratch. Okay, so we are going to add some more functionality to our widget by importing with single tick provider state mixin. So now we are going to do basic setup for ourselves. So you can see the variables might be commented because I am not using them for my purpose. You can remove them if you require it. So just be with me. If you find there are some errors, you will get rid of them as we follow. So this was the color BG color we are going to use. The setup animation is going to be imported now. So this was just init state. So after init state, obviously we need to get setup animation. So this is the setup animation code. So now what we need is setup tween. So for setup tween, we are going to get that code. Okay, so for setup tween, here you can see we have now got the setup tween. So now obviously we have created some animation thing. We have to also dispose it. So now we are going to write the code to dispose that things. So now there are few more functions which we are going to quickly import them. It is basically pre-developed code, but I have now just copy pasting it because you can obviously see it. So I think I have imported maths. It should work, haven't I? Okay, get it. just because I didn't use it, it kind of removed that thing. So be sure that you remove this setup. Okay, so hypotenuse is done. Now function, one more override function, overriding a function. Did update widget. Okay, so now we are going to create one more, I can say, custom painter before getting to the main build function where everything is going to be built. So let me just bring the whole code in front of you now. Just give me, yeah. So here you can see this is the whole pulse paint thing, which will help us to create this animation and do everything which we want. So this is basically the pulse widget, which will create a pulse in background, and the front thing will be called a selector. So that is just kind of a carousel which we use in Flutter. So now we are going to get to the main thing, the build. Okay, so let me just bring it to you now. So let me just give it go through. I think, yeah, it's just too big to fit in the screen now. So here you can see there is absorb painter absorbing this widget dot absorb consecutive pointers, and absorbing controller is animating. If it is animating, then we have to absorb that pointer thing. If some user clicks when we are animating, so it should absorb that thing. So we are using gesture detector, I think. Yeah, gesture detector wasn't used as such. If you are working with it later on, you can just remove this part. So now there is value. Yeah, it's just getting inputting all of the whole main code is just still here. So now there is value listenable. Okay, I can't pronounce it right. I don't know how to pronounce it. Value listenable builder. Here you can see value listenable and offset notifier. So this was, that was the variable which we kind of declared upside up in the code. So this is the final offset notifier. What it will does it, it will notify the whole widget tree when there is some changes in offset. So now this is the builder function. Here you can see for value listenable builder. Now this is the layout builder. We have kind of built the layout whole thing. The size, what should be the size, the circle, container, opacity, and all those things. So I think if when you write this code after just getting through this video, you will be able to understand what the whole thing is. So I'm not getting deeper into these many things. So now we are going to go to the filter selector to work with now. Okay, so let me just again import those. Okay, we will do it afterwards as we require those things, otherwise it will again get removed anyways. So we are going to create a stateful widget called filter selector. Yeah, I think, yeah, this is right. So these are just basic imports. So now again for filter selector, this was taken basically from Flutter tutorial things. So if you want to change it or if you want to see something else, you can just simply go there and check this code out. So now these are basic things which we are going to use in our filter selector in non-stateful widget. Okay, now coming to our main widget. So here these are some things which we are going to use. So these are some controllers, some item color function, just to get identified which color is currently being selected by the user. So now we have to init the things, we have to initialize. So this is basically init function which we are going to work with. This is a page controller to control the page, and this is on page change, or these are basic functions which we will use to get the counter change. So this is the filter tapped. So this is basic logic when what should happen when the filter gets tapped. So just like I said, if we initialize, we have to dispose the controllers. So this is what we are going to do. Okay, so I think we are not done yet. Oh god, sorry. Yeah, some functionalities are still remaining. So we need one more function called build carousel. So here you can see the whole code for it. Let me just import what things it just require. Okay, so this is build carousel function which uses carousel class, I can say. So yeah, let's get started then. Okay, so I'm just getting the whole carousel class in just one go. I just thought of it, well, it will not fit in. So here you can, I'm just scrolling down slowly, so in case you are just writing this thing, you should be able to get those things right. So this is basically, you can import maths. So if you are just following, just let me get you there. It is just, I have imported maths as math. Yeah, and the errors will be gone. Okay, they are not yet. Some more functionality is still remaining. Okay, so we'll get to that thing. Yeah. So let me just make you go through this carousel thing. So here you can see the carousel class starts. Here we are working with paint children. Okay, so this is just basic requirements what the carousel class requires to work with. Then this is paint children function, how to paint the children, I mean just what paint should be there for every block or every button. And this is just basically should repaint function. So now to work with or to remove more errors, what was the, yeah, so we now have to get one more class called filter item. So yeah, it's just again, oh yeah, big class, I can't write through it. So this is the filter item class. Here you can see what the things are required for filter item class to work with. Here this is basically the builder function, what it does or what it, yeah, here you can see one more thing is just like raised button exception. I think you can deal with this. I think there is an elevated button now, but I just didn't change it because, yeah, who cares. Okay, so I think it should work. What is happening? Okay, so in case if you are following, I made a slight mistake while placing this function called build carousel. So build carousel should not be outside. I think so. Wait a second. Let me just check what just now happened, from which part it just gets connected. I don't know. Okay, so I think this just got one more entry. And what we are going to do is we are going to write this build carousel function inside our selector function so that this code works. So in this filter selector we have to get this build carousel function. Let me just confirm with that, is it so? Yeah, okay, yeah, so build carousel has to be inside this. It was just my mistake, I kept it out. Okay, now we are going to get to our main thing, the build function here. So let me, we are at right page now, no errors, everything is good to go. So now in the builder function what we are going to do is we are just adding some scrollable widget to scroll through things. Just move page scroll physics controllers, layout builders. So here you can see how it should look like. So once you are done with writing this code, now we are going to our main dot dart where this basic home page widget was created. Now we are going to create or make some changes here. Okay, so these are some functionalities which are required in state builder class. The index to control the filter notifier and all those things. So now just like we have to create a function to get notified for what to do when filter changes. So again we have to create build selector. Yeah, the filter color selector. Now we have to import that class here. See, this is how it works. Yeah. Now we have to initialize the whole thing. Yeah. Okay, so we are using vsync. Now if you are familiar with animations, you know that vsync doesn't work with normal builder class. It just require some tick provider state mixing. So we are going to provide it here now, so that vsync error is gone. Yeah, it's gone now. So now I haven't disposed the controllers here because it was not my duty. Okay, it was my duty, but I just became lazy. I was lazy to do so. So it is on you that you should dispose it when you don't want to. So now this is the main builder function. Now here we have to import our pulse class. And these are the things which you will require to create this animation. So now let's just check all this code. Already I've ran this, but just in case if there are some errors.